Hi everyone, Eric here for Ask Our Experts. We're talking about memory in this series, and to help answer this episode's question, we're bringing back Steven Gann. So now that he's here, let's see how he can help. Steven, I2C is one of the most popular communication protocols between components in embedded applications, and there are different speed modes for it. What is I2C high-speed mode, and how can I take advantage of it?
Great questions, Eric. So high-speed mode is a special operating mode for some I2C devices that allows them to communicate at 3.4 megahertz. It's defined by the official I2C specification, but not all I2C devices actually support it, so you're going to need to make sure that your I2C host and client devices both support it. If your hardware supports it, you can enter high-speed mode by sending a normal I2C start condition, followed by the high-speed host code, and then another I2C start condition. This will instruct the I2C client device to enter high-speed mode, and then it should stay in high-speed mode until you send it a stop condition. To ensure that your high-speed I2C signals are clear between the host and the client, you'll need to make sure that the pull-up resistors on SDA and SCL are sufficient. So there's a simple formula for determining the ideal resistor value based off of the maximum rise time the devices will accept and the total capacitance of all the devices on your I2C bus. This will allow you to calculate the ideal resistance, and then you can choose a common resistor value that is less than but close to that ideal. So in this example, the calculated ideal resistance would be 472 ohms. And in that case, the common 330 ohm resistor is sufficient.
That's a great explanation on how to use I2C mode at high speeds. Thank you, Steven. Viewers, as Steven mentioned, be sure to check out our app note on the topic and visit our website to learn more about our extensive I2C EEPROM product offering. Links to those are in the description of this video. And as always, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know when we have more insights from our experts. We'll see you next time.